We're working on making carbon materials sustainable and affordable on a very large scale. For about 15 years, we've known how to make structures and we know how to control properties. We can make this strong. We can make it much stronger than steel. We can make it electrically conductive, almost as conductive as copper and aluminum. And we can make it more thermally conductive than copper and aluminum. And then what do we use to make this? We use hydrocarbons. We use hydrocarbons, of which there is even too much. But when we use hydrocarbons to make these materials, all the carbon stays in the material. And so we make no carbon dioxide. And in fact, we free up hydrogen. So if we could make these materials inexpensively, which also means using a limited amount of energy, we could have a way to transition our material systems to a state that uses much less natural resources, uses natural resources that are much more abundant and easily extracted. And essentially, we could get rid of the CO2 emissions of all these materials that are called the hard to decarbonize materials, like aluminum, copper, steel. And we could also get rid of all the mining associated with those materials. But we just have to make it cheaper, which means that we have to understand the chemistry and how it couples to the physics and the engineering of the systems that we use to make the nanotubes. Right now, there is, frankly, a disbelief that this is possible. And this is something that has plagued any really new technology that changes how we do something on a very large scale. The Kavli Foundation is going to support a very foundational study on how we can understand the reactors where we make these materials. And so what the Kavli Foundation is giving us is a way now to bring together about a dozen groups in universities, as well as national labs. I like the fact that the foundation is calling it an exploratory grant. The way this grant hopefully will go is we'll make advances, we'll make advances that then lead us to make a better reactor, better systems for making nanotubes, and then we will continue to work and do more fundamental science that will continue to make things better. We will help this field accelerate and get off the ground also in terms of these materials being used more broadly, and that we will continue to work on the fundamentals that will make the materials even less expensive and more affordable later on. And I think that the Kavli Foundation is going to be fundamental for this.